Hello everybody, my name is Firethodas and welcome to this video, this build guide video. In this video we are going to talk about this single master build, the new build, which is for the class Arcanist, as we can see here. This is a level 20 Arcanist build and it is the first video of this mini series of video guides of for the single masteries of Grim Dawn. Now I chose to play this build, of course, with the Arcanist Mastery, but I chose to create a spellcaster which will be using the Trojan Sky Shard as the main damaging skill of this build. So my goal is to max out everything that has to do with the skill and try to make this build as much as powerful. So I will tell you about the skills I'm using, I will show you the items and a little bit of gameplay. For the skills, I put points on Inner Focus because we need Spirit. Since this is a spellcaster, Spirit increases damage of our spells, of our elemental damage, magical damage overall. So the more Spirit we have, the better. I will max out the skill Inner Focus. It gives lots of Spirit and some offensive ability. Offensive ability for dealing critical damage. And after this, of course, I'm using the Skandra's Elemental Exchange. This must be toggled to make any effect. It is a skill that gives you elemental damage, a flat number, energy leads per second, some physical damage converted to elemental damage, it increases energy regeneration. Now, since these video guides are made also to be helpful for new players of Grim Dawn, elemental damage, when we see a flat number of elemental damage, this number is divided by 3, because in this game we have 3 elemental types of damage. We have cold, fire and lightning. So when you see 52 elemental damage, it means that 1/3 is boosting your fire damage, 1/3 your cold and 1/3 your lightning damage. The 16% physical damage converted to elemental, of course, means that the physical damage that you deal, your build deals, 16% of the physical damage is converted to elemental damage, and again this conversion then leads to the division by 1/3 for each one of the types of elemental. So with this one, our attacks deal more elemental damage and we get more elemental damage from the conversion of physical damage. I'm going with the Overlord add-on of the skill because with this one we have a chance for one of the following. Burn damage, frost burn damage and electrocute damage. I'm not really interested in burn damage because burn damage means fire burn damage. Burn damage, electrocute damage and frost burn damage are the damage over time effects types of elemental damages. So we have fire damage and the damage over time effect is burn damage. We have cold damage and the damage over time effect is frost burn. And for lightning damage, the dot damage over time dot effect is electrocute. So we have a chance for one of the following. When you see a chance for one of the following and you have these three types of damage, it means that every time you attack you deal one of these three. So this chance of for one of the following is actually about 33% chance to deal each one of these three. And it also gives more elemental damage as a percentage. When you see elemental damage as a percentage plus 22% elemental damage, not plus 22 elemental damage, a flat number, but a percentage. This means that it boosts all three types of elemental damage equally. So, the plus 22% elemental damage increases your fire damage by 22%, your cold damage by 22%, and your lightning damage by 22%. And this is a good add-on. Of course, I'm going to max out these two skills, and later I will probably work on this one here, because of the critical damage that it provides and the more frostburn and electrocute damages. I'm also using the Mirror of Ereoctis. This is a great skill, a very powerful skill. It has only 3 seconds duration, but when you activate it, you get 100% damage absorption. This percentage of damage absorption means that All incoming damage, all types of incoming damage are useless because you gain this immunity. 100% damage absorption means immunity to all types of damage that your enemy deals against you. So for 3 seconds you become immortal actually, this is what it means. And it gives 15% damage reflected on level 1 of course. And this damage reflected means that when an enemy attacks you, he takes back 15% of the damage that he attacks you with. So if an enemy's attack deals 100 damage, then he will take back 15 damage because it is 15%. Simple as that. And of course, putting more points here, it increases the damage reflection. It doesn't increase damage absorption because it makes no sense. 100% damage absorption means you become immune to all incoming damage, so there is no need to go even higher. Of course, this is one skill that we will grow further in the future. And yeah, because of the damage reflected actually, not for any other reason, there is nothing else in this skill. It is the damage reflected and the damage absorption. And last but not least, of course, we have the Trojan Sky Shard, the main skill of this build for dealing damage. It drops 3 shards upon the target area. It is an area of effect AoE skill. It is not a single target skill. And we can see the meter radius here. Of course, I have maxed out the skill already. It was I was trying to max out the skill since the beginning, since when I started playing with this character. I came here, level 10, I started putting points here, and up to level 20, I maxed it out. So, we have only 2.5 seconds skill recharge, which is okay. We can reduce our cooldowns of all of our skills with items. And this one deals cold damage and lightning damage. To make this skill even more powerful, of course, we can increase the skill level by equipping items that provide plus to all skills or plus levels to this skill. Another way to increase of all of our magical attacks, spell attacks like this one, the damage output is to put more points on spirit, of course, here, spirit. And another way would be to find items that provide more elemental damage to these types, cold damage and lightning damage. But I think that the best way to increase the damage of the skill, since it is a skill that it deals 2 types of elemental damage, not only one, then I think the best thing is to find items that provide a percentage of elemental damage. But this percentage of elemental damage would need to have huge numbers of percentage of elemental damage, not just 20 or 30%, maybe more than 100% to elemental damage. Items that provide so big numbers of percentage of elemental damage would help greatly increasing the damage output of the skill. This is what we will be doing in the future. We will try to fight items like this. Now, I'm using the Frozen Core. This one gives more cold damage, and also it gives Frostburn damage over 3 seconds. It adds Frostburn damage, which, as we said before, it is the damage over time effect of the cold type of damage. And also it freezes targets for 2 seconds. This is very important. Freezing targets is very important because this build will not be playing with shields. It is a spellcaster. Spellcasters are more sensitive to physical damage and all of these things. So we have to be careful. We have to try to somehow crowd control our enemies if we can do that. And to do something like that, freezing target helps very much on this aspect of the build. So this is a skill that we will put more points later into because it also increases Frostburn damage and also it increases cold damage. The 31% cold damage means that it increases further this 700% cold damage that we see here. And later, of course, in the future, we will max out this one. We will talk about the skill in the next video when we have start working on the skill. These are the skills I'm using up so far, up to level 20. I haven't put any points on Devotion system. I will start using Devotion after level 40 probably. and we will start talking about it then. First, I prefer to decide the final or almost the final version of the build, exactly what skills I will be using, and then to see what items I can fight for my build, and then I will start working on the devotion system, because this way I will know which constellations I will be needing the most. Now for the items. For the items, as we said before, we need to try to find items actually that provide stats that benefit this build. I have, first of all, I decided to play all of the single mastery builds with self-found items, so each build, each character will be using only items that this character have found during its own playthrough. I'm not using any stashed items except for components, because I have plenty of components in my stash. At components, you can find components everywhere actually, and I don't want to waste any time farming for components. This is why I'm using components of my stash, to save time and create more content. But all of the other items are self-found, and we will keep playing these builds with self-found items and see if we can make the best out of these builds. So for items, I'm using some items now. Actually, I'm not going to go through all of these items, it isn't necessary. These are just some items, nothing important. The best thing we have to remember is that we need some specific attributes on our items that will benefit our build. These attributes would be, first of all, spirit helps very much, because this is a spirit build, it is a spellcaster actually. Spirit increases our magical damage and all of this thing, our energy regeneration, so it is a mandatory attribute for this build. Physique also is very useful, because it allows for equipping even more powerful armor items. We need physique to survive. And also it increases, as we can see here, it increases regeneration, head regeneration, and the chance to avoid being critically hit, which is very, very important. Very important. Other very important attributes that we need are elemental damage, as we were talking before about skills, because we want to improve the damage output of our skills. So elemental damage on items is very important. Especially a percentage of elemental damage, because when you fight on your items a flat number of elemental damage, this flat number works only with the attacks that you deal with your weapons, not with your spells. To boost your damage output of your spells, you need to fight items that provide a percentage of elemental number of elemental damage, not a flat number of elemental damage. And this is what I'm trying to fight and equip on my character. And I have, for example, this one here. It says plus 7% elemental damage. It gives physique, canic spirit, and offensive ability and bleeding resistance. Of course, two other more very important attributes for this build is health. We need to get health on our items as much as possible, and of course all types of resistances, because resistances will keep you alive. It makes sense. It is simple as that. So overall, we need resistances on our items, health, spirit, and elemental damages as a percentage. So these are the most important stats that we got for our items. Now, for example, I'm using this one. It gives vitality damage, percentage to elemental damage, more energy, offensive ability, and energy regeneration and bleeding resistance. This one gives some acid damage, and canic spirit, offensive attack speed. This one gives elemental damage, health, very good resistances. This is an amazing item for level 12. Pierce resistance, poison acid, and elemental resistance. I'm using this one because of the physical spirit and armor. We have this one with elemental damages, main attributes, and very good resistances. This is a very good item. This is actually a superb item for this build for now, because first of all, it provides 18% skill cooldown reduction. This is very important. Skill cooldown reduction is also a stat that we will certainly need for this build. As much as possible, skill cooldown reduction helps casting all of our skills much more frequently. Especially this skill is very important because it gives immunity to all incoming damage and it keeps you alive. And of course, we will need to be casting this one as often as possible. So having 18% here helps greatly, very much. As we can see now, this skill has 3 seconds skill recharge time. If we equip this one, this skill has 2.5 seconds skill recharge time. It is only half a second, but half a second in games like this one is a good amount of time reduction for our skills. So as you can see, we need for our offhand, we need as much as cooldown reduction as we can get. Of course, this skill is this item is amazing also for the 18% to all damage, which means it increases all of our types of damage by 18%. It gives spirit, casting speed. Casting speed is also very important for a spellcaster. What else? We have the skill Reckless Guardian, 5% chance on attack to spawn, and we have these things. And I have attached the mutagenic core, the component on this item, because it gives some poison damage, and also it gives the skill Poison Bob. I have this blue item, it is a Shadow's Grasp. This item is actually not very good for this build, but I'm using it for the pierce resistance mostly, and it gives some chance to avoid melee attacks. Okay, this chance is super small, but avoiding melee attacks and projectiles will be a very good thing for this build if we can find items that provide this chance to avoid melee attacks. And we have a medal, pierce damage, lightning damage, electrocute damage, offensive ability, elemental resistance, and things like that. As you can see, we try to stack on items that provide all of these important stats for our build, this build. So, now let me go and kill a couple of enemies. I will activate my Scandra's Elemental Exchange skill. I will teleport maybe to Berwitz Village. And I will kill a couple of enemies so you can see what we do with this build. Let's go this way. Where are the enemies though? Here they are. I'm using a pistol for now. As you can see, the Sky Shard is a very powerful skill. Of course, I have maxed it out already. And for level 12, it is a very powerful skill. For level 20, it is a very powerful skill. I cannot go this way. Chak, chuk. In the future, I will probably replace this pistol with something else. The bad thing is that we need to invest in more cunning points, attribute points on cunning, if we got to use powerful pistols and ranged weapons. And I want to put most of my points on physique and spirit, so I will not try to invest many points on cunning. And this means that I don't really know later which item I will be using in the weapon slot. But we will find out in future videos of this build miniseries. As we can see, the Sky Shard kills everybody without question now, for now at least. Sometimes I'm using poison gas bomb that I get from the mutagenic core, the component that I put here. And sometimes I'm using the fire blast, this skill, which is very powerful for the early stages of the game. Of course, all of the magical attacks that we deal, these magical attacks that come from components that we attach on our items, these magical attacks also get boosted by spirit, for example, or by elemental damage, percentages of elemental damage that we get from other items. So these items, these skills also benefit from all of these things. And we use the Mirror of Ereoctis, and when we do that, we become immune to all incoming damage for 3 seconds only. Of course, the bad thing is that this skill has more than 30 seconds cooldown. One way, of course, to reduce it is to be using off-hat items that provide lots of cooldown reduction for our skills. Now we have this guy here. This is the Guardian. It came out because we have this item, the Carvor's Conjuring Bone, which comes with the skill of this Guardian, the Reckless Guardian, which has only 5% chance to activate on attacks that we do. Your inventory is full. Throw this to your enemies and do this move here. Of course, we are holding this pistol here. If we want, we can go there, put Poison Bomb or Fire Blast here, and start using only Fire Blast, and this way we do not use the attacks of our pistol. We use only Fire Blast. Of course, casting Fire Blast all of the time means that you need much more energy regeneration, because it is a spell, it costs energy, and if you cast an energy costing skill all the time, you eat away your energy. But as we can see, it is also a powerful skill, which gets boosted by elemental damage percentages from other items or skills. Let's use some frozen shards there. This skill here, we keep our distance with this build. It is a spellcaster, it is not a warrior, it is not a shield user. It is nothing like that, it is not an assassin. And we keep our distance and we shoot from a distance arrows, projectiles, spells and all of these nice things. And we kill enemies. This is the build, guys, for now. It is a very simple build for now. Of course, it is in the very, very early stages of the build, and we are using a few skills only, not many skills. But this is a single mastery build. We are not going to invest in all of the skills of this mastery, only the skills that will really benefit this Trojan's Sky Shard build. So this is it for the build, guys. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. I will reply as soon as possible. The next video for this build will come when this character reaches level 40. And then in that video, we will talk about the new developments of this build, the new skills that we will be using, some new items probably, maybe epic items, and maybe for devotion system, if I will start using any constellations by then, we will see. I don't know yet. We will see what happens. And this is it for this video. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave a comment below, and I will see you very soon with more videos and live streams. Thanks for watching, and have fun whatever you do.